Hello and welcome back to my show. I hope you're doing well. Let's get to some business. Let's talk about in the month of March, the median price of a home listing reached a whopping $370,000, a 15.6% increase from the year before, while existing home sales went off the charts, never seen in 13 years. So it's a 13-year high. Now, while housing supply is down, it's declined almost 52%. People are still scrambling to get homes and pay even more. Like in some areas in Austin and Texas, they're paying 34 to 37% of the market value. And also, mortgage rates. While mortgage rates are going up, so are mortgage payments. Realtor.com said the monthly payment for an 80% loan for a typical listing hit $1,260 in March 2021. And they're also saying that for price appreciation to go down, there would have to be more of a supply of homes, or the demand must go down and be curbed. So also keep in mind that home sales were up by 9.1% the year before, and with a 15.8% higher price. That's what Zillow reported. And housing inventory, although we're talking about shortages and supply and demand imbalances, there is a surge of inventory and in housing in the following states. Take note. If you want to go there, I'm not so sure though. Los Angeles, Chicago, New York, and San Francisco. I kind of thought that too. But where are people moving to? Mover destinations are Portland, Maine, Bay City, Colorado, Michigan, and Idaho, and Pueblo. While the Washington Post reported that in the month of March there were 900,000 jobs added to the economy, they forgot to mention one little important note, and that is that it's down by 8.4 million or 5.5% from the year before, February 2020. Yeah. And that information is brought to you by the Bureau. I always get that one wrong. Okay. Bureau of Analysis reported that. You want to check that out too. Now, going back to the other market, the oil market, the WTI has bounced back up above $60. And of course, the dollar is weakening, but we learned from my last video yesterday that cash is not trash, people. Okay. Hold on to it. Add that as one of your assets onto your portfolio, because when rates go down and there are prices that can't be beat, you're gonna wanna pull out your cash. That's right. So on that note, let's talk about Bitcoin and how it surged to above 63,000. Ethereum at 2,300. Also in the news, there's another African American who got shot. Unfortunately, this is a sad situation of something that was accidental, unintended, but I'm not the justice system, okay? And I'm not giving hey or nay. I'm just saying it's a tragedy across the board, okay? So, but that didn't stop looters from going to Foot Locker and Nike. But one thing you might want to know about Foot Locker is that they pulled out 200 million, 200 million. And they gave it to the BLM movement, Black causes, good thing, but still they got looted. And Nike as well. Nike pledged to pay 40 million over 4 years to the Black Lives Matter, Black movement. And it said Zero Hedge reported this, so I must give them credit. Where they said that they said Nike was also looted, where back in June they pledged to pay 40 million over 4 years to quote Black community organizations to help them tackle quote systemic racism and police brutality. But apparently they didn't get that memo. But The money's got to go somewhere, right? So after not so much diving into information, where did that go? Okay, that's not the intention there, all right? And before I talk about where the money went, I want to make sure, I was reminded the other day that even white is a color in the Crayola box. So we're all colored people, all right? Let's just have a fair system all across the board. That's the only way we can deal with life. Or that's a fair thing, isn't it? Or is that too? Although that's too much to ask for. I knew it. Okay, so let's go back to where all this money is going. Is it going to better the Black communities? I don't know, but maybe we could ask the BLM founder, the queen of all this. Her name is Patrice Cullors. Now, she advocates for hating white people and defunding police and all of this, and attacking whites. This week or recently, she bought a 1.4 million mansion in Malibu. I guess you guys are knowing which part of the Crayola box that color belongs in, that area, right? So she hates them so much, she's like, I'm gonna go live with them, be around those people I say I hate. How hypocritical. And then she also has 4 high-end homes nationwide that total in $3.2 million. I'm wondering, is she helping the Black cause? Is she going in and giving money to the Black neighborhoods where they're struggling with drugs, violence, gangs, you name it, poverty? Because I'm not so sure anything's getting better in that area. But they say defund the police, right? Then who's going to protect them? That, you know, that comes to mind, right? So that's where Bill Maher comes in. And, you know, he's quite the catch. He's an interesting character. I don't always agree with what he says, but you know what? Sometimes he nails the point, so I'm going to say what he said. Bill Maher complained of March awareness, the BLM and airline crew wearing BLM pins. He said, quote, crew members on major airlines wear Black Lives Matter pins during the flight, Maher complained, then quipped. He says, you know, you can support a movement without constantly being reminded of it. Can I just get a rum and coke and hold the white guilt trip until we land? Good going, Maher. I like that. He also quoted a retired, because of this police, they say police brutality against Blacks. Death of any person is a tragedy, okay? We got to make that clear because we want to clear up our conscience. So Maher quoted a retired Portland detective who said, quote, the community shows zero support. The mayor and the council ignore actual facts on crime. Maher goes to say this. I'm just saying on Portland, it's a cautionary tale because we don't want to live in a world without police. Then it's the purge every night. So you think that's a great idea? And back in 2020, he called the idea, Maher, of defunding the police, he says, effing stupid and a terrible idea. So you can meet halfway middle ground. We can meet together and unite if we're right, or if we have some right ideas and left ideas. We could always find some common ground and agree upon something, even if it's just music, right? I like music. You probably like some same music as I do. Okay, so we could find some kind of things that we like or we agree upon, right? Without creating an all-out civil war like those looters did, right? In Minneapolis or Minnesota, one of those two. So peace all the way. And I want to thank you. That's all the news I have for today. Okay. I got to end it somewhere because, we all got to live life, right? You and I. I want to thank you for your support and for watching, liking, subscribing, and your comments, questions, tomatoes, and all that. And I want to wish you a blessed and a safe evening wherever you are. Take care. And I look forward to presenting you with more new content and keep you energized and alive. And always keep thinking optimism. There's greener grass on the other side. Let's think so, right? Yeah, it's not. Okay. Well, okay. We'll just go over there. Thank you again. Till next time. Bye.